Praise God and welcome to this Friday's edition of the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. Beloved, we are so excited about this word because it's life-changing. It is God setting us on the path of a miracle. I was so excited about it, we forgot that actually this week we have been in a very first marriage seminar. Actually started on Wednesday, and yesterday was Valentine's Day and we didn't even remember it. Join us tonight for the conclusion of the teaching phase. And I believe on Saturday evening, there will be a little gala thing for couples. Come and be a part. The Lord will bless your life in the mighty name of Jesus. You can always call 770-994-3777. 770-994-3777. The Lord will bless your life. We are sowing seeds for the miraculous, beloved. We are believing God that the seeds we are planting, He will use, and we're looking for that blade. We're looking for that blade. As we're inviting you to come and be with us on the 29th of March, Good Friday, to pray at the steps of the Capitol. We're sowing seeds and we're looking for that blade to come up. First the blade. You have to have been listening to me to understand what I'm talking about. Then the ear, then the full corn in the ear when America turns back to God. Hallelujah. Then on that Saturday, the day before Easter, then we have the Resurrection Parade and the Great Rally at the Centennial Olympic Park at 12 noon. God is doing amazing things. We are seeing the results of our intercession in Muslim countries and so many testimonies of Muslims coming to the Lord. Don't worry about ignorant so-called Christians who were never saved turning to Islam. There's no way you can meet Jesus Christ and change to another religion. It's impossible. You were never saved. You never knew Him at all. Remember that he that is born of God is sealed with the Holy Spirit, and no other spirit can get in there. No, you were never born again if you would turn to another religion, particularly Islam. May God help you in the name of Jesus. Pass that word on. Hallelujah. Don't worry, I'm not going to be praying for president or anybody. I'm not running for any political office. My job is to preach the word of God to America. Amen and amen. Hebrews chapter 3 once again. Wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling. I'm using at my staff that wonder where I was going with that. Consider the apostle and high priest of our profession, Christ Jesus, who was faithful to him that appointed him, as Moses was faithful. See, beloved, that's all that matters. Jesus did not worry about the political establishment. He did not worry about the religious establishment. He was faithful to the Lord that sent him. That's my assignment. That's what the every true pastor called of God is assigned to. To get the work of the kingdom done. We are not politicians. We are not preaching. We will not preach the truth. We will not preach the truth so we can get invited to the White House. We don't care nothing about getting invited to the White House. We want to change America. We don't care about praying in any celebration or whatever in the political arena. No, we are called to change America. That's what the apostolic ministry is about. And I stand with every pastor that will preach the gospel and unashamed, or without any apology, beloved. We are called to be faithful to our apostle and our high priest, Christ Jesus. And I'm brimming with joy for the remnant that is standing. I'm brimming with joy for the remnant that is still preaching the gospel. Because I know the word of God can never be defeated. I know the word of God will stand forever. I know the word of God will overcome all the powers that be in this country. Believe me, beloved, the word of God will overcome. God has been waiting on the church. He don't need a crowd. He just needs the remnant to keep pounding in the spirit realm until the blade comes up. And for you, beloved, if you need a breakthrough, the apostle is waiting for the word, the sacrifice he must offer unto the Lord as your high priest. Let me go back again to that example. Remember in the Old Testament, God gave them a tabernacle. It was the Holy of Holies, and then the holy place. You have the table of showbread and the candlestick, and then you have the brazen altar. Of course, after those two, the altar of incense, before you get to the Holy of Holies. Remember, this is the beginning. If you don't offer that sacrifice, you cannot get beyond that very first premise of worship. And what happens, most times we come to that altar and the demands and requirements are made of us. Either we are too lazy to make the sacrifice, or we are unwilling, like the rich young ruler, that turned back. And then we refuse to offer on that altar. Then the priest has nothing to give. Jesus Christ is at the right hand of God, in the very throne room, on your behalf. And the Bible said, consider that he is there. Don't make confessions that will not stand up. Don't make confessions that are idle words. Maybe next week we can talk about it. That he cannot use to offer to the Lord. He cannot worship the Father with it. That will not produce any miracles for you. Remember that someone is in the throne room. So don't you ever say again, if somebody can get a prayer through for you, for me. No, Jesus is at the right hand of God for you. There's somebody there for you. Get right with him. Humble yourself before him. Tell him, Lord, without you, I'm nothing. Lord, if you don't help me, I'm going down. I trust no one else but you. Make your confessions before God. Become a dear child to him. His glory and his grace will cover you. Then come join us, beloved, in praying. Come join us in rallying. The Lord will work miracles. The Lord will credit our account in heaven with testimonies of fruit that came out of obedience to preach the gospel. There is joy in heaven over one sinner that repents, and we are the evangelists God has sent forth in this generation to get the job done. Are you ready? Are you willing? Are you able? Remember, you will take the sacrifice. Make it today. We love you. We'll see you next week. That's what you got. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting on you.